We got a question from one of our viewers about motorcycles, and he wanted to know why his hands went numb when his motorcycle was throttling. So here to answer our question is our chief medical expert, Dr. Robert Markison, who knows everything about everything having to do with the hands. Thank you, Dr. Markison. What can you tell us about vibration and motorcycles and over gripping and that sort of thing?
Yeah, I think when you try motorcycles, depending on your size and weight and grip strength and so on, you really do want to road test a motorcycle and see how much transmitted vibration is going through the hand. In addition to avoiding resting on this vulnerable part over the ulnar nerve on the hand, you want to have a padded glove to mitigate, reduce any vibration trauma to nerves and vessels going through there. And so throttling, braking, and so on, you want to make sure that the mechanism of the motorcycle is not too hard. And because the greater the vibration frequency and amplitude, the greater the risk of injury, depending on the unique anatomy of your hand. And no two hands in two people or the same person are created equal, which means you may or may not have much tolerance for vibration trauma.
So Dr. Markison, you were pointing to this bone in the hand. Are you specifically saying don't rest on that bone, or is it the soft tissue around?
It's the soft tissue near the bone. The little floating bone is pisiform, P-shaped in Greek, pisiform bone. And then right to this side of it, so here's the bone, right to this side of it is the nerve. And that nerve branches here, goes out here, goes out to this side of the ring finger, but it also gives life to 15 out of 20 small muscles, intrinsic muscles in the hand. You never want to be bearing weight on there or exposing it to unnecessary vibration trauma. That's important. And if the vibration is going across the hand, then it can compress the median nerve, the carpal tunnel nerve that goes to thumb, index, middle, and the other half of ring. And so test a motorcycle before purchase and realize that there's a fair variation, variability in amplitude and frequency of vibration.
So this is really interesting because you're affecting not only the median nerve, which is nourishing these fingers, but also the ulnar nerve. So
that's
the
right.
Whole hand could actually go numb.
That's and, right.
Yeah, you talked about the vibration of the motorcycle. And can you talk a little bit about we did an episode on this before, but maybe just to refresh our memory about the micro trauma to the blood vessels.
Right. And it's not very common in motorcyclists, more common in jackhammer operators and heavy vibrating equipment operators. But the vessel called ulnar artery goes here and arches across the hand. Most of the time, it'll join up with the deep arch of circulation from radial artery, but about 10% of the time it doesn't. And so you can, with heavier, you know, high force vibration, clot off that vessel. You can drive it into vasospasm short of clotting it off. But the big print addition is when you clot off that vessel, the fingers go white and pale and you have poor tolerance for cold and so on. So that's a vascular problem in addition to the nerve problem, because the nerve and vessel run right next to each other, in this case through a little tunnel called ulnar tunnel, which is more surface-like, superficial to the carpal tunnel.
Okay, and then if we could compare driving a motorcycle, riding a motorcycle, to playing a musical instrument, one of the things that we talk about a lot on this channel is nuance and the tendency for people to overgrip. So maybe when you're trying your motorcycle, you would see how little effort you have to use to get it to respond to you. It's kind of like driving a high-end car where it's responsive to small suggestions.
Right, but the big variable is if you're off-road biking and you've got a very irregular surface, gravel and so on, then you're at greater risk because it's the terrain and the shock absorber of the motorcycle that'll be very determining and defining in terms of your physical tolerance. So when you test a motorcycle, you have to go over smooth and rough terrain to really see what's happening and what you can tolerate riding safely, not over gripping, but not getting in a dangerous situation.
And how about gloves? Are those, I think you might have mentioned that earlier. Are they recommended?
Absolutely, yes. Padded gloves, they do two things. One, protect you by absorbing some of the vibration and also keeping those segments of vessels warm, because gloves is an external applique. Warm the vessels, relax their muscular walls, and improve in and outflow circulation.
And I know you're picky about gloves. Do you have any buying advice for people who might be thinking about getting a motorcycle glove? How would you know when you're trying them on? Will they just fit like a glove and feel good right away? Or how do you know what a good glove
is? I think so. And just like any good cyclery that sells bicycles, a motorcycle dealer will have various gloves, and you just feel it, and you compress it, and you see your tolerance for it, and you get it onto an actual motorcycle and try them and see when you're riding whether they're absorbing the shock.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Dr. Markison, for explaining this to us. I think, you know, there's probably a lot of people who could really use this advice. So we're really happy we have you.
I never want to take away people's fun. I just want them to have safe use of brain-hand linkage, because that's what keeps us happy and independent.
Okay, so we'll have fun, but we won't destroy our hands in the process.
Right.